Hey guys, Frank Rich here from MassStaticMuscle.com. And in today's video, we're going to talk about the leg press and go over the importance of your foot placement when executing and performing this exercise. We all know that the squat is going to be, for some of us, the best mass building exercise to help us put on mass on our legs. But as we've discussed in previous videos, it's not going to be an ideal movement for everybody. Depending upon your particular structure, your mechanics, the squat is not going to be optimal. So this is where the leg press is going to come into play. If you're really going to build the best set of legs and really have an ultimate mass-aesthetic physique, you're going to have to maximize and utilize the leg press into your training. And one reason why it's going to be so beneficial and so important for you to be able to do this is because you're working within a stabilized environment. When you're performing a squat or other pressing movements where you're not locked into a fixed position, there's a lot of things that can go wrong. So to really get maximum output with your leg training and with your muscles, you really want to be in a secure, stabilized environment. And that's where working with the leg press is going to really come into play for you. Now, a few things that we really need to discuss before talking about the actual placement of our feet is the actual mechanics and execution of the exercise. Obviously, you're in a fixed position, you're seated, your lower back, your glutes need to be pressed hard up against that pad. The minute your hips begin to roll over and your lower back and glutes come off of the pad, you've now altered or changed that distribution of that load to other muscles. So make sure when you're performing every single rep, they're locked down hard, your lower back, your glutes are driving hard into the pad. Now with your feet position, you want to have an even distribution of weight across all of your feet. You don't want your inner feet rolling in. You want to really even consciously think about keeping the weight distributed on the outside. This is going to help keep your knees from buckling in because you really want that knee pad in line with your feet. So those are just a few important factors before we even discuss the foot position on making sure that you're getting the most out of it and you're keeping the tension and load on the working muscles. Now, why is foot position important? Well, obviously, we know that setup and execution of exercise is really going to determine how the muscle works. So as we can see, with the leg press sled, it's a very large surface area. So depending upon where your feet are gonna go, that's really gonna determine where that load is gonna be distributed. Just like if we were to change our hand position on a bench, it's gonna change how that bench press works on muscles. Same concept, same mindset, go. So if our feet are high, it's gonna work in one particular way. They're placed in the middle, it's gonna hit the muscles a little bit differently. And if they're lower, it's gonna hit the muscles, obviously, in even a different way. So we're gonna go over to that. We're gonna kind of discuss how you need to be setting up your feet, what muscles and what the intent needs to be with each particular movement, and how you can get the most out of your leg press. All right, first position that we're gonna discuss today is gonna be a high and wide foot placement. Now, obviously, this is gonna depend and vary depending upon your leg length and hip width. So, but what you're really trying to get here is your feet as high on the platform and as wide as possible without your hips really having to roll under. So as you can see, I'm kind of pointing my toes out here, really opening up my hips. And then as I perform this movement, I'm really thinking on the descent or on the eccentric portion of the movement, bringing my heels together, almost as if I'm sliding my feet, almost scraping gum off of the bottom of my foot on the pad here. So this is really targeting and working those hamstrings. So high and wide, really focus on driving your heels together as you roll through the descent, really targeting and hitting those hamstrings really, really hard. Guys, let's talk about the quad focus leg press execution. So what I'm focusing on is putting my feet as low on the pad and platform as possible and really keeping them close together as well. Obviously, once again, this is gonna determine upon your body's mechanics, your particular leg structure, but you really wanna get your feet low on the pad. Now, it is gonna be okay if the weight is distributed a little bit on your toes. Just make sure you're not pushing and driving through your calves. So this is gonna be where you're really gonna wanna start with a lighter load. I mean, don't worry about the pressure and strain on your knees. What you're thinking about here is really breaking at that knee first, trying to drive those knees up and over my toe. This is really gonna get the quads activated, get the quads involved in this movement. So low on the platform, feet close together, trying to keep the weight distributed closer to the balls of my feet without keeping that tension and load on the calves. This is really gonna hit those quads hard, really get those quads activated, help blow up the front of your legs. Third and final foot placement, guys, is gonna be a neutral stance. Now, this is probably where your feet are gonna wanna go if we were to just sit down and get in a comfortable position. So find where you're most comfortable, and what we're looking for here is we're looking for an even distribution of load through our quads, hamstrings, and glutes. So this is gonna be the movement that you're really gonna be able to push the highest level of load. So if you have a day where you're really focusing on increasing load through weight distribution, go with a neutral foot stance. This is gonna, like I said, get all those muscles evenly involved. So it's gonna have to be in a comfortable position as well, but we're focusing on a slow descent, slightly letting our knees come to the outside of our shoulders. This is just gonna get a little bit more depth, get those hamstrings a little bit more involved in it, but make sure you're keeping your execution tight. Once again, focusing on those cues that we gave you at the beginning, driving your lower pad or your lower back into the pad, keeping the weight distributed, really focusing on driving your knees out as you perform this. A neutral stance, guys, is gonna get glute, hands, quads all evenly activated and really allow you to push some heavy load and increase your weights. Now, obviously, you can perform each one of these movements in a different day or in a different set, but one of my favorite ways to utilize the leg press is in a mechanical drop set. So this is where you're gonna be able to do a drop set without changing the weight or changing the load and staying in the machine the entire time. What we're gonna do is we're gonna slightly alter the mechanics for the execution of the move. So starting with the feet low on the pad, getting that quad focus intent, we'd perform 8 reps first. Then we'd bracket, not get up, but immediately move our feet to the outside, high and wide platform, targeting those hamstrings a little bit harder. So we slightly change the execution of it, but have it touch the load. Then once we perform 8 more reps, we'd finish off by doing a neutral stance. So we're getting glutes, hands, and quads all working at the same time. So mechanical drop set, advanced way to really work the legs, really get a metabolic workload through that, but really tax every single muscle in those legs. Give it a try, guys. All right, guys, there you have it. Leg press execution and the importance of foot placement. We went over 3 different foot placements, went over exactly what you need to do, and I can utilize them in one set. So really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Hoping you can apply it and helping you build that nice big set of impressive legs. If you did, make sure to give you a thumbs up, guys. I really want to know what you thought about this. So drop a comment below. And if you know somebody that would find value in this video, please send them over our way and share this. If you haven't yet done so, make sure to subscribe to the channel. We're releasing videos every single week, guys. So you want to make sure that you're notified exactly when those videos come out. And what we're also doing today is we're giving away 5 tips to help you accelerate muscle growth. So if you are hit a plateau or looking for some advantages and assistance within the gym, hit the description box below. There's a link right up there at the top. Hit that button, enter an email address, and we're going to send over the 5 tips to help you accelerate muscle growth. Like I said, guys, really appreciate you tuning in today. Hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll talk to you soon.